Today we are focusing on two magnificent tarantulas from Colombia, which we documented in the wild and at the same time bring a lot of joy to keepers in the pet tarantula hobby. So stay tuned and don't forget to watch out for our bonus clip within this whole episode. So let's just start with a short scientific introduction to the genus. The genus Pseudopolopus and its type species Pseudopolopus axialoatus are native to Bolivia, and according to the 2020 publication by Nentwick et al. And Nomen Dubium, since the type material from Strand is completely lost. Other members of the genus Pseudopolopus were transferred to a new genus called Spinosa tibiopalpus, including the species from Trinidad. So this new combination, Spinosa tibiopalpus trinitatis and another one from Colombia, there is another new species described from Trinidad named after Guy Tansley from Bugs and Stuff, so check out his YouTube channel for more spiders documented in the wild. But today we're not talking about scientific papers, but more about the presence of two new yet undescribed species of Pseudopolopus, Spinosa tibiopalpus, or whatever they're going to be called in the near future. So starting with the original blue booty tarantula from Colombia, for many years, I would say well over 10 years already, the tarantula community knows about a species called Pseudopolopus species blue, originating from mountain ranges within the country of Colombia. They are available almost all around the globe for many years and go for as low as $25 in Canada for spiderlings, and in Europe even cheaper, for around 5 euros for a sling. So hobbyists in the US tend to pay a little bit more for this species, maybe due to the lack of local breeders of this very Pseudopolopus species blue. So during our last field trip to Colombia in 2020, we were finally able to encounter a healthy population of Pseudopolopus species blue in the wild and document their natural behavior. So thanks to a friend of ours, we were given details about where to find them, and therefore we were able to take as many pictures of them as we wanted. Pseudopolopus species blue is a dwarf species of tarantula, so reaching around 3 cm in body length, which translates to around 1.2 inches, and leg span diagonal would be around 5.5 inches, so it is sure a small tarantula species. They have urticating hairs present underneath their blue patch of iridescent hair, so the color blue, as within most animals, is not due to the actual pigment coloration, but it's actually called a structural color. So light hits special structures on the very cell of the setae, and that causes the wavelengths to bounce in a certain way, in the very short wavelength way that results in the color blue. So if you're interested about the blue coloration, specifically in tarantulas, make sure to read the linked scientific papers in the description of the video. Recent studies by Foley et al. 2020 suggests that tarantulas are able to recognize blue colors and therefore have evolutionary advantages in courtship and predator evasion, for example. Here comes our bonus material. So we found another Pseudopolopus species in the wild in Colombia. It is called Pseudopolopus species Kurzhaar, or short hair when translated the words to English. So this tarantula species has no blue coloration at all, but with its contrast of different shades of darkish brown and black coloration, it is a true jewel in my eyes. They have quite an attitude and know how to defend themselves when disturbed, so definitely a moment when we shouted out loud in joy when we found this species on our field trip to Colombia. So sometimes you just got to be lucky. So if you enjoy videos like this, where we showcase tarantulas in the wild and give you some brief advice on how to keep them back at your place as a pet tarantula, leave a comment down below, let us know what type of tarantulas you have. Maybe you currently keep a Pseudopolopus species at your collection, would be great to know more about it. And also suggest the video to friends of yours and leave a like on the. And now we're heading over to another very closely related species to this Pseudopolopus species blue. To my knowledge, it was first found by our team, BirdSpider CH, to be more precise, by Rito in the year of 2014, when he was traveling around the globe by himself in search of tarantulas and enjoying life. So in the same year, 2014, we created a small blog post on the website feature a picture of this new Pseudopolopus species yellow blue, but we are not specifying any name to it, so yeah, the name just came out later. So this Pseudohippolopus species has unique yellow and orange colorations alongside the typical blue colored patch on the opisthosoma of the tarantula itself. So it's like a more polished version of the classic Pseudohippolopus species blue we know for so many years. It's one of the few truly yellow colored tarantulas out there. Between 2014 and now 2021 has changed a lot, not only the world around us, but of course the availability of certain species in the pet trade. In the year of 2018, another team found this tarantula species in the wild and made them with successful breeding available in the pet trade. As with the closely related species, Pseudohippolopus species yellow blue has well over 100 spiderlings per exec, so the exec itself is almost as big as the young adult tarantula spider itself. In 2019, we were able to visit the location where Rito found the tarantula spiders a few years before, and we were happy to see that there is still a healthy population with various sized tarantulas present. We did not think about how big this tarantula really grows. To my understanding, I would no longer count this yellow-blue variant as a dwarf species, such as a Pseudocosmos or Heterotele species from Central Africa. They reach sizes of around 4 cm in body length, translating to well over 1.5 inches, and in leg span that means almost 6 inches. This Pseudohippolopus species yellow blue from Colombia has the stripes of Pseudohippolopus trinitatis and the blue coloration of the close relative of Pseudohippolopus species blue. So combined with the fact that there are other close tarantula relationships between Colombia and Trinidad, such as Neoholotele incei and Neoholotele fascia aurinigra, there is definitely a huge potential of it being all of them very closely related. So let's see what the future brings us here. The husbandry for both of the mentioned Pseudohippolopus species is fairly simple and not worth a dedicated video section. So use a container which is big enough and provide enough substrate for them to burrow in. Temperature wise, you should keep them between 22 and 26 degrees Celsius, translating to 71 to 79 degrees Fahrenheit, and just don't overdo it with the moisture. Provide a water dish in the corner of the tarantula's enclosure, or just keep one corner wet, whatever you might prefer. Just don't flood the whole tarantula enclosure, since you maybe saw in the habitat shots, the soil and the environment is pretty dry and just occasionally gets rain. So this actually is the species Rito found a few years ago, and it's a beautiful species with a lot of yellow and a lot of blue on the opisthosoma. Really nice. We will take some pictures and videos of it, of course, and then of course release it back to nature. So awesome find. Thanks Rito for giving us the location details for it, so it was an easy find.